Hi guys, today we decided for going for a few interview questions, which is for 6+ years. This is for all the people, all the professionals who have more than 6 years of experience. We are mainly focused on that kind of, the total experience person. And then we are going for the interview questions for the SQL and PL SQL. I have noted down a few topics on which we have to discuss. So basically, we have discussed on a few topics like one of the questions which are asking in the interview from the performance tuning definitely is one of the most important part which each and every interviewer will going to ask you at a 6+ experience, and you must have to memorize the steps that how you are going to answer. I think I told you that it is preferred that you guys can note it down somewhere whenever you prepare for your interview, right? So you can note it down in your copy that what you are going to ask to the interviewer. So at that moment of time, when somebody asks you this question, you don't need to memorize all these things. You know what you're going to ask. And because you are preparing for the interview, giving an interview and working in a common environment, these are two different things. Okay. So as you're preparing for interview, you must know what they're going to ask and what you're going to answer. So better that you have some points. So basically you can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points, because I am taking an interview for so many days. So I prefer if the candidates have knowledge and he has his 5, 6 points which he are able to tell me in front of me, so I can understand, okay, he has some idea. So it is preferred that whenever you are planning or preparing for an interview, any good questions, go topic by topic, start from topic. No need to go to randomly pick, okay, today I will read about triggers, one day I will read about cursor, I will find today on YouTube, okay, let's go partitioning, something like that. No, it's better to go one by one topics so that it will take your strength. It will maximum take, a month or less than that. If we only on weekend you prepare for 1 hour, so in 8 to 10 hours you are able to prepare all the important topics which are going to ask you in the interview. Okay, so let's start today. Okay, let's start today for the interview preparation point. The first, let's go for the easy one first. Okay, I'm planning to go with some the complex topics. Easy topics, definitely I will let you know. The complex topic I will let you know today as I plan for pipeline functions. I will let you know what pipeline function people can ask you, what is result cache, how it is work, and how you read the explain plan. This is the one of the most important question they are going to ask you. What is, what is the explain plan? If you see explain plan, how can going to read the explain plan? What is pipeline functions? How do you use the bulk collect? Okay, and result cache. These 4, 5 important topics I will cover, and rather than that, few normal topics on which interviewer can ask you the questions. Just like I've just taken a topic, this very important topic is function and procedures. The question is coming for us. This question is very important question for less experience also, for the senior level people like 6+, what they're expecting in the interview. Tarshan, I don't have any courses because I'm not from any, I'm not a particular teacher and I'm not from any institute. It's all about my experience. In the last 16 years, I'm working in IT and all from the database side. So it's all about my experience I'm sharing. I am not a teacher. I'm not from an institute. So I don't have anything such like that of any course. But we can go topic by topic if you guys want. Okay. So, okay. This is an important question, function and procedures. So normally, when the people ask you the difference in function and procedures, so everybody knows, either you have 2 years, 3 years, 6 years, 10 years. The things you have to tell what, but better you have to know the answer how you are going to ask it. Not every time function must return a value and procedure not return a value. It's not a one-line answer. You have to go like, function is to compute something and procedure is to execute something. The first line you have to say. The second line, okay, the function must have a return value and procedure may not. Is a return keyword used when you're creating a function? But in procedure, we can create a return keyword. It's a question. Here's the question coming from the 6+ interview question. What happened if you write return in a procedure? Because return is a mandatory keyword in function. If you don't write return in a function, the function will give you compile time error, right? But in procedure, if you write return, what happened? This is a very important question. So you can check in your code, any of the code. So what happened? I'm telling you, you can tell the procedures to the interviewer. Whenever the code, there is no compile time error, the procedure will run smoothly. When the procedure compiler comes to the return at the time of execution, okay, it will return from here. if any code written after that return, it will not go beyond this. It will return from the return class. This happens if you write return in a procedure. This is an important question, and it will ask for the people 6+ years. Okay, there is one more question coming in function and procedure itself. The people are saying, okay, what happens suppose if I write, can we write, you are saying the function is to compute something and procedure is to execute something. Okay, so what happens if I try to make in a DML statement? Can I write in a DML? Can I write insert, update and delete in a function? So the answer is yes, you can. Normally this thing, but you have to answer like this. Yes, you can write insert, update, delete, and the function will work exactly what is designed to do that. But this is not the basic nature of function. That is why Oracle gives us the procedure. Then he said, if this is not the basic nature, then why we are creating this? Then why we are going to do this? What is the benefit, pros and cons? The pros and cons is here, by using this type of function, if you are using any DML operation in the function, we cannot call that function in a select clause. In a select, suppose we have a function get underscore salary, update underscore salary, anything. This is your creator function. Create function UPD underscore salary. You are passing employee ID, EID, and this function will return the updated salary. Your update here, update employee. If this updated salary function, you cannot call in a select. Select UPD underscore sal, comma something. You cannot call this function in a select clause. This is the question they are asking you in the interview. If you write a DML, so can we write that function in select clause or not? So we can say no. This is the limitations, that you can write the DML statement in a function, but we cannot call that function in a select statement. These are the difference. These are two important questions is coming if you are talking about function and procedures. Okay, that's done. This topic is done for 6 to 10 years. Okay, the one topic I am coming is basically the things are coming from you is explain plan. I'm coming because the process performance tuning question is the important question, and people can understand more from the 6 to 10 years. They want to know more about 6 to 10 years people. Okay, so one more question I'm coming for that from the indexes. You can go and read from Google or anywhere what is the difference between global indexes, local indexes, reverse indexes. Note on these topics, or my videos available. Reverse indexes, because everybody know about index. The 2 to 6 years people, the less accessible, know about indexes. For you guys, you have to understand what is global, what is local index, what is reverse key indexes. And do you know there is a like operator? If we have a like operator, suppose I'm putting select star from employee, where name like percentage, VISHAL percentage. If I have a index on employee name and you're using like, so can this index will be work or not? Okay, so we have a special type of indexes for the like operators also. You have to go to YouTube or Google as exercise and try to find out what we can do. This is the specific answers. If you give that answer to the interviewer, they're very happy to know that, okay, you know such about the indexes. One more here, the question is asking, if suppose there is a table and there are lots of insert and update are going on. There are lots of insert and update is going on the table. Okay, so in that scenario, as in a previous lecture, I told you about reverse key indexes. But here the question is, suppose insert and update. So what happened with the index of the table? Okay, when we do the analyze indexes, analyze table name, analyze table name, compute statistics, or analyze index name, compute statistics. So basically, how the histogram, what happened when we do that? How the histogram will be updated. Okay, when you use the word histogram, I'm telling you, when you use the word histogram is updated, this is a very good impact of the interviewer. You have to understand what histogram is. 2 to 3 lines, 4 lines is enough for an interview. The interviewer can know, okay, you know a little bit about how the compressor will work. So just take an example, what happened with insert and update. For suppose this is a book. Okay. And in your your college, when you first started the DBMS, you know the index chapter will start there. Its indexes work like index. In every book, if you go to the last, there's index, the A coming on page number 5, B coming on page number 7. So what happened if lots of pages will be destroyed? If we suppose we tear off few pages or we insert few more pages in the book, Okay, so how the index will work? So index will not work because that index is not correct in the book. In the same way, in the table also, if lots of data will be inserted or updated or deleted, we have to rebuild the indexes. So this is the question they can ask. You have to say you have to rebuild the indexes. Okay, alter table rebuild index is a command. You have to remember, you have to just tell you have to rebuild the indexes. If you say how you have to rebuild, there is a command, alter table rebuild indexes, you can rebuild. Otherwise, you better the interviewer can ask anything. Suppose interviewer asks, do you want to rebuild or recreate? You can definitely say, I will prefer to drop index and create indexes. This is definitely the preferable option if it is possible in our environment. Okay, you can always use, because every business purpose or business need or environment is different. So if our environment is support to drop and create indexes, so we go with drop and create indexes. That will be better, and that will be always, you know, always good instead of rebuilding. Okay, so next question, next topic I'm covering today is you know, about pipeline function. Okay, so the question is, what is pipeline function? This is the important topic, standard topic. If somebody is asking what is pipeline function, so you have to let him know what is pipeline function is, why pipeline function is used, and why pipeline function Oracle gives. Okay, so pipeline function are simply, you know, code you can pretend in database table. Suppose you have to answer like this. Pipeline function we are using is a ability, Oracle points ability, that we can directly query the function. If in a scenario, if in a business scenario, we have a requirement that we don't want to query the table, we have to query a function, or we are creating a function and we want to fetch the data from that function. So Oracle gives an ability that we can create a pipeline function, and we can directly use something like that. Select star from your pipeline function. I'm telling one example how this will work. Okay, I'm telling an example how this will work, and that will be easy to understand how this pipeline function will be work. Okay, so by the way, but the functionality you can understand, this gives the ability to use select star from function, and that's why we are using the pipeline function. This gives the option select star from PL SQL function. So suppose anytime you think that you can use it to select star from function instead of a table, and it might be useful. Okay, the pipeline function can be queried like a regular table by using a table operator. You have to tell all these words as exactly I'm saying. You have to query the pipeline function using a table operator in from clause. How? I'm telling you. Okay. So suppose, for example, I am giving an example here. For pipeline function, you must have a pipe. You must have a type. Create. So I'm creating a type. Create type. Number underscore entity. I'm creating a type, you know, type create number as a table of number. Okay, so this is the first thing. Every time whenever you write a pipeline function, you have to create a type. In this type, the function will return the value. Okay, now I'm using a function, creating a function. Hope you all can able to see my screen. Create function. Okay, I'm creating a function. Create function. Suppose row underscore generator. Okay, I'm passing a variable row underscore in as in PLS integer. Is a row is in parameter PLS integer, and if this is return, what is returning? This type num underscore entity. Here you have defined pipelined. This is the keyword. Pipelined as, when you use this keyword pipelined, it means this is created a pipeline function. Normal function is what? Create or replace function, function name, that is happen, it return a value. It just return varchar to something, but here in pipeline function, this is what you, just a two line code, you have to understand, memorize for interview purpose. You have to tell it, return number I, num underscore entity, this num underscore entity is what? Whatever creating a type, this type. The pipelined as or is whatever. Begin. This is one of the interview questions. Somebody asked what difference between as and is. I'm telling you. Begin. End. In begin, you just like for I in one dot dot rows row underscore n means what are the in parameter we are passing? Row underscore 1 into row into n loop, just like a normal for loop, but here is the keyword. You have to use pipe dot row in bracket I, okay, and loop. That's it. And there is coming a return. So there is one more question is coming. I'm coming to 2-3 questions here. Let me first write the code. I think we are able to see the screen. Okay. In loop, right. And when you have to use the query like this, select a star from, we have an operator table in bracket row underscore generator in parameter, we're passing row in suppose 10. When you do this, select star from row underscore generator, it will give a value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Because we're passing 10, we are just pipeline the value row. So here is the interview question is coming in the interview when you are saying, okay, the question is coming interview for the pipeline function is why this function is used. What is pipeline function? So you know the pipeline function gives the ability to do select star from PLSQL function. We have to use by table operator is used to fetch the data. And whenever you're creating a pipeline function, you have to create a type on which this is the return type. And in the create function, we have to use a pipeline, a keyword. See, create function row generator. I'm using a row in PLS integer return num underscore tt pipeline as. And whenever we're making a loop, we have a pipe keyword. Just like when we're using a collections, we are doing append or bulk collect or something, right? Append dot this, append first, last. We can do pipe dot row and there is a return. Now, this is the one question they understand. Okay, you know the pipeline function. Now, the question is coming, what is this return? Well, if you remember, whenever you are creating any function, okay, the function is coming with return, the name, L underscore name, return L underscore salary, something is returning. But this function has a return clause, that is empty return clause. This is the important interview question to hear. He has to understand that you know about pipeline function is not, why this empty return clause? Why return not returning anything? We have to just make return. We have to write return because this is the functionality of a function. That function must return a value. It must have a return keyword in the function. That's why you have to write. But why it is empty return? Because in a pipeline function, the pipe row statement is responsible for returning data, not the return statement. This is the one line answer, sure short answer, okay, and correct answer. The pipe row, this is responsible for returning the data, not the return statement, not this return keyword. But we are using it because this is a function. This is the basic nature of function. The function must have a return keyword. So we are using return, that is empty. It was a pipeline function. And this pipe underscore row, this is responsible for returning the data. This is all about pipeline function. Okay. Hope you understand this question for interview purpose. I think today is very less people have joined the call as compared to the previous lectures. So I think there are very less people in the group who is more than 6 year experience. I think so. But that's okay. So let's go very quickly, but have the few more topics I have to cover. Okay, the one thing I have to cover is the interviewer can ask you the question. Suppose one query is running one time or two time or three times, continuously running our database, it is coming faster, or how should it give the result faster? And the next time somebody will run, so you have to return about, or some he can directly ask you about result underscore kaise. So you have to know about result underscore kaise. If you know this concept, doesn't matter the interval ask or not, whenever you're asking whether the query is coming faster, the subsequent executions of the query, you can directly come to the result underscore kaise. You can tell the interviewer about result underscore kaise. So it will make a good impression. Okay, you know about it. This includes in Oracle 11g. Okay, the query result kaise is used to store the result of SQL query. Okay, result kaise is used to store the result of SQL queries for reuse in subsequent executions. By caching the result of queries, okay, Oracle can avoid having to repeat the potentially time-consuming and intensive operations that generated the result set in the first place. Okay, so this is basically what it will store the result of the query. So how you can see that, how the data is storing? Okay, he is asking the question. So you can directly write a query. Sir, I can write a query. Select star from V dollar parameter. Hope you guys know about V dollar parameter. What is this? Okay, I'm not going to explain. You know about V dollar parameter. Select a star from V dollar parameter where name like result kaise. Capital result underscore kaise. When we run this query, go and run in your database also. It gives you four things. The first is result कैसे मूड द फर्स्ट थिंग द सेकंड सेकंड थिंग व्हाट इज गिवन रिजल्ट कैसे मैक्साइज थर्ड इट विल गो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस थिंग ओके इट विल इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द इंटरव्यू रिजल्ट कैसे मैक्स अंडरस्कोर रिजल्ट एंड नंबर फोर इज गिव इज ए रिजल्ट कैसे रिमोट एक्सपायरेशन दिस फोर थिंग्स इट हैव स्टोर्ड व्हेन यू गो सर्च स्टाफ कंप्यूटर और पैरामीटर इट गिव्स यू फोर थिंग्स तो यू हैव टू टेल योर यू नो इंटरव्यूअर दैट व्हेन यू सी दिस रिजल्ट कैसे मोड ऑपरेशन इन माय डेटाबेस द डिफॉल्ट वैल्यू ऑफ दिस इज मैनुअल okay if you see when default value is it can be enabled we have to enable this if it is manual means by default it is not using result kaise we have to enable it there are three way to enable it you can use via hint you can use alter system okay alter system or alter session okay or explicitly request the caching right so these are the things you can if you can change this by default it is not using this is enough for an interview answers okay result kaise max size it is saying how much size of the byte as the name defined as how much size of the byte it is storing for the result kaise this type of things they can ask you in your interview to understand okay you are getting this point or not okay result underscore kaise the third thing I am telling you about the query performance okay the people are asking if when you run the query okay and the query is suppose I run a query and the query is not working well we have to sue the performance tuning of the query okay This is a very important question. It is asked for any level of experience, either you have 2 years or you have 20 years. Okay, this is the only question what the interviewer can ask, and he wants to know that how much knowledge you have on database and how much you work on database. And do you have a real knowledge, real project knowledge or not? So the question is how the performance tuning you have to see. Okay, the first question normally I told you in my last video also, but still I am repeating here. Either you have number of experiments doesn't matter, but you have to say the same answer. You have to note it down. Answer is you have to ask the interviewer the two things. Sir, if the query is not performing well, there are two scenarios. The first scenario is the query is working fine till yesterday, or the last run. Whenever the last run was, the query was working fine, no problem at all. But today, when I run, the query is taking so much time in today's run, and it is stuck. The first scenario. And the second scenario is you can ask sir when the query was first delivered suppose 6 months before a year before whenever it was delivered it was working fine the time by time degrading the performance of the query is degraded okay and this is the scenario so what happened if suppose interviewer saying what will do in both the scenario the second scenario if suppose the query was working fine suppose 2 years before when it was written and the time by time consuming the performance of the query is low reversibility is taking 5 seconds after 3 months it is taking 10 seconds then after 3 months 30 seconds and 1 minute one month before it is 5 minutes and today it is stuck for 10 minutes in this is the scenario if this is the scenario happens it means it is because of the data is increasing in the table that's why the performance is slow so we have to go rebuild the indexes recreate the indexes or use partitioning if you have used partitioning once the scenario to customer driven system okay I'm tell you 1 second to see let me complete this okay so what happened in this scenario a performance tuning problem so you can see we have to use partitioning rebuild the index recreate the indexes analyze the table your problem is solved the statement number 1 if you are saying the query is working fine and you have to see what happened today why this query is not taking time here you have many options you have to tell to the interviewer the first thing definitely you have to say is start with explain plan In my today's lecture, I have covered one more important topic is how this explain plan will be read. Okay, somebody asking is when you see the explain plan, what you will do? Okay, so I am telling you next 5-10 minutes how we read the explain plan. If you just note it down these words or up from my lecture or from Google or anywhere you can find it or Oracle Docs. If you note it down how the explain plan can be read in 5-7 lines. That will be enough for crack the interview and that will be enough for interviewer to satisfy him that okay you know about explain plan okay so he can ask you the first thing what you said if I have a query which is not performing so what I can do I will first do the first step is explain plan
You can do explain plan for on the query, and explain plan will come. So here's the question. I'm not going all the stuff. First, let's go on the explain plan. What is explain plan and how you can read the explain plan? So you have to understand that explain plan is a representation of access path that is taken when a query is executed within Oracle. Sorry, the whole line answer, please remember, memorize, note it down. An explain plan is a representation of the access path that is taken when a query is executed within Oracle. Okay, so the query processing can be divided into few phases. You can start like this. When you start like this, interviewer understand, man, this guy has some idea about explain plan. Okay, so query processing can be divided into few phases. The first is syntactic, means they check the syntax of the query. Whenever you run the query, first thing is syntactic, check the syntax of the query. Second thing is semantic, that check that all data exist and are accessible. Why, suppose I am writing a query and the table does not exist, right? So the first second check is semantic. Okay, syntactic, check the syntax. Semantic, check the data object exists and are accessible. The third is view merging, means rewrite query, add join as base tables. There are a few tables that you can see the explain the query run. Oracle will rejoin with this, the views and inline views concept. Okay, the fourth is statement transformation. Okay, he can go the complex structure into similar ones where appropriate, like subquery merging, transaction. The fifth is optimization, determines which access path he has to rule. RBO, CBO, now everything is default CBO, but in the interview you can say the optimization, Oracle has to decide and which path he have to view. Next is QEP generation, it means query evaluation plan generation, and then QEP execution, means query evaluation plan executions. Okay, so these are the phases of when the query will run. When you start like this, then it will be impressed. Now the question is, when we see the explain plan, and you can see the many things. So how you can interpret the things? So you can say the access method, there are access method in details. The first is FTS, that is full table scan. You have to know, you know what you have to do. Now you have to do anything one by one. In few lines, you will be okay. And he is to understand that, okay, that you are getting the point. Okay. So now you're coming from explain plan reading. I told you what is explain plan is. You have to tell that one line, how the query access. You can tell the 7 features, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. When you tell about these points, then he understand. If you forget about 7 at time of interview, tell 5. At least you know that you have understand how the query will run. Now the question is how you are reading the explain plan. So now, sir, now I have explain plan. I run the explain plan in front of me. Now, whenever I am going to read the explain plan, the first thing I check is a full table scan, FTS. What is the FTS? You tell by yourself. Now I check the FTS. FTS is the operation. The whole table is used up to the highest watermark. Use this keyword. Whenever giving the interview, use this keyword. When I see FTS, full table scan, it means the whole table is read up to the highest, up to the HWM, highest watermark. When we are using this word, this is a good impression of the interviewer. Highest watermark, then you no need to wait for him. You can see the highest watermark is the last block in the table that has ever had data written into it. So it doesn't matter if suppose my table employee ID is equal to 1, I want to get up employee ID is equal to 1, maybe employee ID 1 in the first block itself in Oracle. But my queries using full table scan means if my table have 1000 blocks, the query will go and search for this employee ID 1 in all the 1000 blocks. Okay, so in that scenario, this is called full table scan. In full table scan, the whole table is read up to the highest watermark, and the highest watermark is the last block in the table that has ever had data written into it. Okay, if you have deleted, means you can say that I have deleted the data few times back, but still why it is going to the highest watermark, you can say go to the truncate, because truncate will reset the HWM. This is also difference between truncate and delete. So whenever somebody asking the question, so they are expecting that you can use the highest watermark keyword when you're talking about truncate. So truncate reset the highest watermark back to the start of the table. Okay, this is the first thing, FTS, you can see. The second thing you have to check about the index lookup. This is you have to tell by yourself, no need to wait for the interviewer. First I will say the FTS, the second I will check what is the index lookup by my query. I can see index lookup is the 4 options: index unique scan, index range scan, index full scan, and index fast full scan. Okay, so remember, I'm not writing it, I'm just repeating one more time. The 4 methods of index lookup, index unique scan, index range scan, index full scan, index fast full scan. What is index unique scan? It means the method for looking with single key value value in your index. Like suppose I'm writing select star from employee where EID equal to 1. I'm giving a unique value to this. This is index unique scan. If I have index unique EID, we must have to go with index unique scan. If it is not going, there is some problem. So this is coming. This is how is the index unique scan. Index range scan, if suppose, means you have to index range, you assign the column data via range, like where EID greater than 500 or EID between 500 to 500 to what you can say, 1000, something like that. We given a range, that index range scan. When what is index full scan, index fast full scan. Index full scan is basically work in RBO only, rule-based optimizer. It is not in CBO. So it's okay if you don't say that, okay, index full scan, index fast full scan. So I have just idea that index full scan is capable in RBOs, not in CBO. And I'm working in Oracle 11G and 12G. Nobody's going to work in nowadays in 10G. So that is okay for your answer. That is good. The third option you have to say after the next sentence is joins. Now I have to look for the joins. In my explain plan block, joins coming in three types. One is short merge join. This is, you can see an explain plan, nested loops. And the third is coming is hash join. This is, you can see in your explain plan. So what you can see is, you can see the interviewer is here in is, you can see the interviewer is. So these are the things I can see in my explain plan and try to understand how this join is going for the short merge, how going nested loop or going to hash join. These things, if you're talking about explain plan, he is fully satisfied. He's not going to ask you a single question. I'm telling you, at least for the 12 years, at least when you are going for a developer or designer level, not an architect, but till that, he's not going to ask a single question. He is happy for the answer you have given. Okay. So this is the first thing you have seen. Explain plan will be explained in briefly to the interviewer. Okay, then you have to tell that you have to see the query. The lots of things I explained in the previous video also. When the first thing I have to check the explain plan, this is the way I have to show the explain plan. Then I have to see why this full table scan or range scan or this is happening. I have to rebuild the indexes, recreate the indexes. The third thing you have to do, or the second thing you have to do, the third thing what you have to do is, the third thing what you have to do is, in this query, you have to take that, you go for the indexes, both analyze table or analyze indexes, you have to follow. The third thing you have to check, and okay, and somebody is asking the question, the time of interview also, my procedures is not working. One of my procedures is taking time. That procedures have so many queries. How do you find out which query have the problem? I don't know why interviewer asks this type of questions, but still they are asking that my procedure have hundreds of query, hundreds of SQLs and that procedure is taking so much time. So how do you find out which query time? If they're asking this type of question, so simple, you can ask, sir, I will ask your DBA to generate the AWR report. AWR, use this word. You AWR report. So you have to ask the interview. You have to tell, I will ask AWR report and I will read the AWR. Then he will ask, do you know how to read the AWR report? I said, yes, I will open the AWR report. I can go the top five queries. The AWR report is the AWR. Whenever you, if anybody of you have experience in AWR report, you can see the AWR report, the SQL statistics. That SQL elapsed by time, elapsed by CPU times. Okay. So this type of things we can see in AWR report. And from there, you are able to find out. And I then from there, I can see, okay, my query number, query ID, there is a query ID, SQL ID, something, hexadecimal numbers are there. This query is also written in the AWR report. This query is taking by query by elapsed time, SQL by elapsed time, SQL by CPU time. I can check, okay, this query left time is high. So I will check that SQL. I will take that SQL and run that SQL, because there is no magic and there is no, you know, there is no thumb rule that if there is a procedure having 50 of SQLs, how can I find out which SQL is taking time? So I have to take the AWR report, AWR report having the top five SQLs, and I can check for SQL statistics, the SQL by elapsed time, SQL by CPU time, everything is coming here. From that report, we are able to find out the query which is taking much time, and that query I will use to run the same funda. I will take the query, use the explain plan, see how it is running, how it is not running. If any problem, I will do the index monitoring. Index monitoring also funda. We will do index monitoring and all this thing, we are able to find out the issue. So this is what he wants to listen. So that's it about that. And what more questions from interview? I think we covered so many topics. One more thing, let's say, there is a question about partitioning, if you know. From Rokel Levanji, this problem is solved, but still I'm asking the people, still asking the question, because normally we are using range partitioning. Because the database, the RDBMS is we created, you know, for our databases or a system many years before it is running as it is. So we are supposed to be creating a range partition. Okay. And range, this is the question of interview. And range partitioning, we are creating a range on basis of suppose salary. Okay, so we have a salary in, we have a one range, one as a salary 1,000 to 2,000, range 2,000 to 5,000, and range 3,000 to 10,000. So what happened if they try to insert a record with the salary 10,001? So there is no range defined for that. So till Oracle 10G, it will give an error because of range partitioning. But we can resolve this problem by using interval partition with the extension of range partition. So that will be automatically generate at that time. If there is any data coming like this, Oracle will generate a new partition for this at the runtime, and there will be no error. Okay. So this is the question they are asking on the interview time. Now I'm coming to the question is save exceptions. You have to understand the save exceptions. Okay, how the save exception will work on the bulk collect. You can take and see any example how this bulk, when you are doing a bulk collect for all RDX in our query dot first to dot last save exception. Here's the way we are using save exception. So what happened if there is any issue coming in this one to suppose you are running for 1 to 100 records, any issue coming 100 record, any exception is coming, whole transaction will not roll back. 90 transaction will be inserted as it is. We are done. If the two records have error, it will go to the exception block by using save exceptions. Okay, so that is that the way we are using save exception. The third thing, the one I think the last topic I am covering today is the query rewrite option. Because whenever they are talking about the SQL query performance, you can easily say the most of the problem will be solved if we use the query rewrite option. The query rewrite option is this, you know, it doesn't matter your experience level of 2 or 5 or 6 or 10. Okay, the writing of SQL is always a tough job for the people who is not writing SQL frequently. Okay, and there is no solution of that. There is no shortcut. You for the things I've just told a few minutes before, you can go and memorize it from for the interview purpose, but for the SQL writing, it needs a practice. And for this, you have to work with somebody who is real working on that. Or you need with your own project to check the queries which are written previously by other developers. Check the queries, try to run by some other way. Just like in mathematics, every problem has many solutions. In SQL query also, you can write the query in many different ways. So SQL query writing, I'm again telling you, you can go and practice for the with clause. W-I-T-H, with clause query, how it is writing. So when somebody telling you that this is the query I want, so try to make a clear picture what is the output they want, how the output looks like. If the take a picture, the output looks like this. He want the ID, he want his max date, max enrollment date, suppose max enrollment date and amount, following this type of things coming. And my data have my table have millions of record or billions of record is there. Where suppose there's an example, every day somebody is going to Amazon.com and they try to purchase. Everybody has their unique ID. Suppose I am my ID on Amazon. I go my ID suppose 1001. Okay, I'm going to Amazon.com and try to do some purchase. Every day on the database there's a row is inserted that 1001 is coming. Okay, on date suppose 4th September 2020, I do a purchase of 50, something like that. Or whatever, and the same 1001 is coming on 3rd September, 2 September. Then hundreds of records can be possible for one 1001 record. Okay, and accordingly, that for this employee 1001, there must be ID in this table 1, 2, 3, 4 coming. And suppose our requirement is we want that how there is ID is coming. There is a product ID he bought, and product ID and his description is under table, which having the product ID and description. So we have to find out which record he purchased and what is the maximum price of that product. So in that scenario, first thing we have to understand that what they want. They want this. If you want to join both the big tables, so it will be time consuming process. we want, suppose in the mind, we want a table which have, suppose this table have ID and so many dates. If have a table in our mind, which table having ID and one date, so it will be easy to find out that, okay, only one record against this ID. So what we can do, we can use this with clause, just a with clause from here in right, suppose with N1 as select this ID, table ID, comma, this employee ID, max of date, your product, if product wise, order by this. Now, this my N1 block, it give me only one row, product in the table ID, product ID, what is the maximum date he shop, and which product is shop. Now, I have one row. Now I can join this N1 block in another table, which having the product from that row. So that will what happen, we don't have to join this 100 of records in the product table, we have to join only one row of this product table, which product will be purchased. So by this way, if you rewrite the query will be faster and will definitely improve the performance. Okay, and we can use materialize, there is a many hints we can use nowadays, like parallel hint can be faster your performance, materialize view hint, whenever you are using a with clause, something you can use materialize view hint, it will be faster your performance. So this type of things. So that's it. I think there are very less people today. So thank you. So if any question, you can ping me, call me, whatever, my WhatsApp is there, my US number is there, and my email ID is there. Okay, thank you guys. Thank you so much. Let me know if you have any questions. Bye-bye.